LDBC. This is your boy Coach Shelton Harrison. You're live on the Coach Shelton Harrison Combat Sports Show live. Okay, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and drop this video and drop it quick. You know what I noticed? I noticed that Jeff Horn, as a champion, is willing to do what Manny Pacquiao didn't want to do, and that's fight all the other champions. I'm trying to understand the reason why people don't like this guy. You know, why people not giving Jeff Horn their full support for defeating Manny Pacquiao, because that's what the hell he did. He beat Manny Pacquiao. Folks, that's just how it is. That's just the way that is. He defeated Manny Pacquiao. But, you know, you can see that, you know, this guy is not getting everybody's full support. Huh. He wants to fight all the other champions. Manny Pacquiao wanted to avoid all the other champions and fight his quote-unquote mandatory, who, let's just be honest, they thought that he was a cherry. And this cherry was very, very sour because he beat the hell out of Manny Pacquiao. Take it however you want it. Take it however you see it. Take it however you envision it. That's fine. I'm not finna argue with your opinion. I could care less about your opinion. My opinion, Manny Pacquiao got beat up and he lost the fight. That's just how it is. We can come on here talking about dirty headbutts and all this other crap. It's a fight. It's a fight. And it's funny how y'all didn't say that when Marcos Maidana was doing that to Floyd Mayweather. Oh, it's a fight. Well, you know, well, it was a fight. So Manny Pacquiao should have been ready. He should have been ready to go them rounds and put that work in. So if he wasn't ready, then that's his own fault. Okay, so be it. I can care less. So be it. But I noticed that Jeff Horn is immediately wanting to do what Manny Pacquiao would not do. You mentioned Keith Thurman. No, he didn't want to fight Keith Thurman. You mentioned Errol Spence Jr. He didn't want to fight Errol Spence Jr., you know. You mentioned some of this young up-and-coming talent. You mentioned Terrence Crawford. He definitely won no parts of Terrence Crawford. But Jeff Horn is already calling these guys out. Already calling them out. See, we may not be impressed too much with Jeff Horn's skill set, but, man, you got to love this guy's attitude. I mean, you got to love his attitude. Like, I'm actually every day finding myself being a fan of Jeff Horn just because of the fact that he want to fight the other champions. It don't matter, man. The guy want to fight the other champions. I full support it, man. Shoot. I'd be 50-50. If Jeff Horn in the fight, you know what? I still pull for him because he always going to be the underdog. I always pull for the underdog. And, yeah, I like Jeff Horn. I like him, man. You know, that's what you want in a champion. That's what you want in a champion. But, see, people like Jeff Horn, they don't get praised. And, you know, actually, they get criticized or, you know, they get the boot stuck to them for trying to fight all the other champions. That's what happens. Errol Spence want to fight all the other champions. I mean, that's what they want to do. You know, I say Errol Spence and Jeff Horn, they want to unify. And they want to be undisputed more than anything. You know, now, I ain't really seen all too much evidence of Keith Thurman. I mean, Keith Thurman ain't really been, like, you know, voicing his opinion on it or going out and really, yeah, I want to be under. He ain't saying nothing about undisputed. You know, Keith Thurman, in my opinion, he just seemed like he's worried more so about making his money. And ain't nothing wrong with that. But, you know, for the overall picture and overall sport of boxing, that's bad. Because we need to see undisputed. We need to see undisputed. We need somebody to collect all them titles. That's what we need. We need undisputed. And there's nothing wrong with being undisputed. Because I always say this, if you fight for legacy, you'll be rich. If you literally fight for legacy, you'll make a lot of money in boxing. See, I think that this endless well of money for boxing, I think it's going to run out. And the days and times, you know, of people being just casual fans, you know, I think casual fans are going to become smarter. And casual fans are really going to understand that, you know what? No, these are crap fights. The fights are crappy. And I wish the average casual fan would start looking at, like, would start paying attention to the odds. You know, even if you're a casual fan, pay attention to the odds. Oh, wait a minute. This guy like a plus 500 underdog. Oh, he's finna get in and get beat. Nah, we ain't watching that fight. If more fans stop putting their money out into this crap, we'll start seeing unification bounce. We'll see an undisputed champion, easy. And we won't see so many undefeated fighters. I don't really care about a fighter, you know, having losses. It's almost like, you know, like, for example, Adrian Broner. The guy's only had two losses on his record, but people still calling the guy a bum. And he lost to two world-class fighters. And I'm trying to figure out, so why the hell does that make him a bum? No, he not winning the big fights. No, the big fights that we think that he should be able to win, no. But why the hell does that make a bum, a guy with only two losses? I mean, people don't get it. He's won more than he lost. Same thing with Amir Khan. He's won more than he lost. And Amir Khan got some good wins on his resume. But, you know, the guy loses a fight and, you know, he's a bum. I don't get it, man. You know, the difference when I cover UFC, when I cover fighters in the UFC or when I cover MMA, you know, these fighters can have 10 or 12 losses, man. But the fans don't stop supporting them. The fans don't start calling them bums because they know. In MMA, you one kick, you one submission away from being a loser. That's it. I think the MMA fans, even the casual fans of MMA, they've already accepted that fact that their favorite fighter gonna lose. They've already accepted it. And it's easy to accept because when these fighters lose, they don't sit back and they don't, you know, have a pity party. They don't get missing for months, man. You see them back on social media, they back going at training again. These fighters, these guys take a loss, these guys are gone, man, for months at a time. I mean, I'm just saying. But that's what it is. Yeah, I call it the Mayweather effect. Everybody, you know, think that they owe is going to make them money. Stupid. Just stupid. But Jeff Horn and Terrence, I'm sorry, Jeff Horn and Errol Spence Jr., they want to become undisputed. I see nothing wrong with that. I mean, everybody in every weight class should all be thinking about being the undisputed champion. That need to be a goal for everybody. Not just a money fight. We need to get in there, and the best need to fight the best. That's how I need to work. I don't even care what organization it is except for Blackout Promotions. If it's Blackout Promotions, I don't support them in anything. And I'm totally blacking them out on everything. But if it's any other promotional company other than Blackout, I don't care who putting it on. Undisputed. Undisputed. And that's what people need to really start talking about. When we interview on these fighters, undisputed. See, I like my setup in the UFC when I cover women's MMA because there's only one champion. There's one. It's not five and six champ. There's one. And you can clean out your division, and you already know who the best in that division is, the person that's holding that belt. That's the person who the best in that division, the person that got that belt. Hands down, bar none, you can't dispute that, except for if you're Holly Holm, because, you know, she was given a title contendership shot, but that's subject for another video. But I'm saying. But see, in boxing, you got guys that will just flat out say, no, I ain't fighting this guy. You got Tim Bradley saying, you know, Manny Pacquiao, you know, these guys will flat out, I'm not fighting this guy. For whatever their reasons are, they ain't fighting the guy. Stupid. Because everybody afraid to lose. I think if these fighters just felt more comfortable and knew that they had a strong fan base that would support them even in defeat, I think these fighters would probably take more risk. Because back in the day, if somebody ran their mouth about you, you fought them. You didn't come out and say, well, you know, that fight don't make financial sense. No, somebody said, listen, I'm going to go in there and I'm going to F you up. Could you imagine? Could you imagine, you know, Mike Tyson, you know, pretty much saying, well, no, that don't make financial sense. When Lennox Lewis said that, you know, he want to get in there and beat the hell out of Mike Tyson. Could you imagine? I mean, man, back then, they didn't shop no fight. They said, okay, let's fight. What none of this, I got to wait, you know, see what my manager say. No, man, come on. Let's get in this ring. Let's get in here and let's fight. See, one thing that I think that MMA does well, for the most part. Now, some fights I do question, but for the most part in MMA, they make you fight the best person. There is no getting around that person. And if you want to duck that person, then that's fine, but they're going to put you on the shelf and you ain't making no money for months. And you're still under contract, so you can't go off and do other things that's going to violate your contract. So, see, you got to fight. You have to fight the person that's the best. That's something that boxing need to emulate from MMA. And I think Al Haymon is trying to get a foot start on doing that, making these guys fight each other. Make these guys fight each other. You know, when Andre Berto announced it, well, you know, yeah, Al Haymon, man, we got to fight everybody. You know, looking like he was all concerned. You're going to get in there and you're going to take a tough fight. You're a fighter. Did nobody tell you to be a fighter? That's what you chose. So you get paid these millions of dollars, hey, let's fight somebody tough for it. I don't want to see no more dudes taking paydays, big paydays, and they fighting scrubs. Nah, man. And we as boxing fans, I don't care if we like the fighter, we shouldn't support it. We shouldn't support it. And if it's a cherry pick, then we need to give the person that's cherry picked our full support. And we need to go against the fighter that we like on these cherry picks. We need to. And that, my friends, is just the way that is. Shout out to Jeff Horn for doing what Pacquiao wouldn't do. This is your boy, Coach Shelton Harris. And I'm done. What are you waiting on? Subscribe.